السلام عليكم children. الحمد لله الحمد لله يا صلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, How are you all today? I hope you feel beautiful today. الحمد لله. Children, as you all know, our first chapter is globes and maps. Now let's study. Okay. Children, we all know we live on Earth, isn't it? Many years ago, people believed that the Earth was flat. Is the Earth flat? No, it is round, isn't it? Yes. Abu Rehan Muhammad bin Ahmad al-Biruni researched and found in 11th century CE that the earth is round. Later, Ferdinand Magellan, a Portuguese explorer, sailed and proved that the earth is round. With the photos of the earth taken from space, it is proved that the earth is round, isn't it? Whenever we see a picture of Earth, it is always in a round shape or a spherical shape, isn't it? Yes, Earth is very big, so we cannot study Earth at a time. There are two important tools to study the Earth. They are the globes and the maps. Today, let's study about the globe. Globe is a small model of the Earth. Globe helps us to show the exact location. Like if you want to point out India, you can point out in the globe. And it shows shapes of different features. It also gives an idea of relative size of land areas and water bodies. The brown color that you can see, the greenish brown color, that are the land areas. And the blue color that is seen, no, that are the water bodies. Now, let's study about poles. The Earth constantly rotates or turns on its axis of rotation. Axis is an imaginary line passing through the Earth that points north and south. The Earth has two poles. The topmost point of the axis is known as the North Pole and the bottom point of the axis is known as the South Pole. Clear, children? Okay, now let's study about the hemisphere. Here, the imaginary line which divides the earth into two equal halves is called the equator. Okay, the line that is passing through the center of the earth is called as the equator. The above part of the equator is called as northern hemisphere and the below part of the equator is called as Southern Hemisphere. Clear? Okay. Now let's study the important lines on the globe and its structure. It is easier to locate places on the globe because of the horizontal and vertical lines drawn on it. When you see a globe, when you observe a globe, you can see a horizontal line and a vertical line. Now let's study about horizontal line. Horizontal line includes the equator. Clear? The horizontal lines includes the equator. The horizontal lines are parallel and these parallel lines are called as latitudes. Clear? They are called as latitudes and the latitudes are numbered. At the equator, it is 0 degree. Clear? It is 0 degree. As it moves towards the north, the degree increases. Can you see? 10 degree, 10 degree N. 10 degree N means 10 degree north. 20 degree N means 20 degree north. And it increases and North Pole is at 90 degree north. Why it is written N? Does anybody know why it is said as north? Because it lies in the northern hemisphere, isn't it? The parallels lies on the northern hemisphere. The same way in the southern hemisphere also the degrees goes on increasing. 10 degrees south, 20 degrees south and the south pole is at 90 degrees south, isn't it? Yes. and the equator is the longest of the parallels. Let's discuss about the important latitudes, important parallels of latitudes. First one, the equator, that is at 0 degree. Next one is the Tropic of Cancer, that is at 23.12 degree north. Clear? 23.12 degree north. Now, Tropic of Capricorn, 23.12 degree south. Next one is Arctic Circle, that is at 66.12 degree north. 66.12 degree north. Antarctic Circle is at 66.12 degree south. Then our North Pole, that is 90 degree north, and the South Pole, that is at 90 degree south. These are the important latitudes. Now, when it comes to the vertical lines, it is called as the longitudes. Clear? It is called as the longitude that touches from the north to south. Longitudes are also called as meridians. The 0 degree meridian is called as the prime meridian that divides our earth into east hemisphere and west hemisphere. Clear? Yes. Now, let's see the features of longitudes or meridians. Longitudes are not parallel like the latitudes. Clear? They are not parallel. They meet one another at the poles, at North Pole and South Pole. All the longitudes are equal in length. Now, I have told you about the prime meridian. That prime meridian is passing through Greenwich. Greenwich is in London, in England. At that place, the meridian is at 0 degree. Clear? The longitudes that are to the east of Greenwich called as east longitudes, and those to the west are called as west longitudes. Now, these latitudes and longitudes make a criss-cross grid on the globe. Clear? It makes a criss-cross like a table, like a column, and it is called as the grid. These grid or the imaginary line help us to locate a place on the earth both quickly and accurately. I hope all of my children have understood what are latitudes and longitudes, globes and maps. Assalamu alaikum.